Hello, I'm Raven. If you're new here, welcome in and welcome if you would like this to be your home. If you're returning, thank you so much for the likes, the comments. The activity really helps the algorithm. I appreciate you. When we get to 1K here or even on TikTok, either one, I'm going to do a giveaway, but I'm doing a giveaway for both platforms so that I'm able to go live from my phone, so it's so much easier, so I can read anywhere. And I've got a lot of huge, amazing things going on, and I can't share them with you yet, but I'm so excited to when they, as they come to fruition. But we're going to get our reading going. First of all, Spirit wants you to know that they see the amazing work that you've been doing on yourself, the growth that you're making, and Spirit, the Divine, is so proud of you. God, Source, Holy Angels, Holy Spirit, Divine Beings, I open myself up as a clear channel and healer to relay messages in the highest white light for the collective. I'm so grateful for the discernment, the wisdom, and the clarity, the clear, concise, easy to interpret messages, and the protection. To be in service of all that is, and to be in service of the collective, I call on galactic beings of light, ancestors of the light, guardian angels of the light, spirit guides of the light, ascended masters of the light, and any other celestial beings of the light that wish to assist me in these readings, messages, and healings for the highest and greatest good of all. Thank you, God's Source Most High, for allowing me to be a divine healer and messenger. I also call in my higher self. Thank you, thank you, thank you, divine beings. And so it is. Oh, in addition, I call upon the violet flame, which is the mirror tick you're going to hear in the background, to transmute any negativity in this reading or any energies that may be upon you if you're watching this for the highest and greatest good for you and the collective. I call upon Archangel Raphael for any healings that may be done or need to be transmitted during this reading and or any healings or readings that I do today. I also call upon Archangel Michael to close the door on all false light, all false messages, and allow divine wisdom to speak through me clearly, concisely, so the messages can be integrated by the collective and myself. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and so it is. So what's up, guys? What have you guys been into? I really feel like some things are about to pop off. Let me know if you guys would like me to do like world truth readings. I've thought about it and just kind of like talk in code because they were pretty popular before when I did them, before my accounts got shadow banned. But if you would like me to bring them here, I will. Just know that everything is taking place despite what it looks like it is for the highest and greatest good. The divine really wants you to know that and wants you to understand that some being, you know, that there's going to be people that in their soul contract, they are not going to be here for the changes of the earth. Maybe their consciousness can expand, but it was written in their soul contract, okay? I'm hearing drink more water. We're going to tap into the Work Your Light Oracle. What's the most important message for my beautiful collective? Trust your path. If you know you would be supported, what would you do? Some of you may be like, feel a sudden urge or need to travel somewhere, move somewhere, change jobs, change locations. You're going through an awakening, energetic upgrades, a new way of being, and integration. I feel some major past life here, Lemuria, Atlantis. Roman times. Some of you may want to check in if you don't already work with Isis. I feel like Isis wants to work with you. She's amazing to work with. Council of Light, Divine Orchestration. You have helpers in subtle realms. Okay, so you have helpers in all realms. Your divine orchestra is here to help you. You just have to ask. And dance with life. Do something to change your energy. So some of you have stuck and stagnant energy and you're being called to dance, move, walk, run, stretch, do yoga. It will help change the energy. Take a break. A life's work is not a season. Get off the treadmill. Some of you here need to take a break. Only take what resonates with what doesn't. Flip and switch genders, okay? As genders are just energy to me. someone here has been just running, working, doing. You need to rest because I feel like you're going to get sick if you don't. You cannot pour from an empty cup is what I'm hearing. We have two more. The Akasha, your guidance is divinely guided. So trust the guidance that you're receiving. It is divinely guided. It is worth trusting. Even if it feels crazy, that like a crazy move, like to another place you've never been, or to go see somewhere, or to take a different job, or to start your own business, follow it. Okay? And inner temple, devotion, tune into the portal of your heart. So I feel like the divine wants you to dedicate some time every day to meditate, even if it's only 5 minutes, or set in silence, like if you're driving down the road and you're really busy with kids and things, and you know, when you're driving down the road to work, or you know, when you have some free time while you're in your bath or shower, you know, set aside some time to tap into your heart, go within. All those answers that you've been seeking are there, they truly are. Let me get some information here. Shuffle these up pretty good. And if you guys would like me to bring back the zodiac readings, let me know. We can do like a monthly outlook, even weekly. Oh yeah, so look, the devil automatically already popped out when I was shuffling. I wasn't ready yet, but so I feel like there are things being brought up from your shadow. Could be people, like maybe for example you used to drink or party, and or even maybe you're in recovery of some sort, because remember, addiction comes in all forms, and you're going to be tempted, you know, people might pop up that you used to hang out with, or, you're going to, you know, temptation is there. I feel like you're breaking a lot of chains, and you may be tested a final time, but you're going to be victorious here, because, you know, I feel like you're, the things that you have broken free from is actually where your life purpose is. What is it in yourself that you had to heal, that you've been through? When you heal it within yourself, or as you're healing it in yourself, or find what works for you, you can help others. There's a Two of Cups here. Someone that, there's a King of Cups, could be Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, doesn't have to be, or it could be a feminine in their masculine energy. Wants a relationship with you. This could be from a past relationship. They are spying on you. I feel like it could be more than one person here. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy could be spying on you. I feel like someone is being led to take a blind leap of faith, possibly to move away from people, places, and things, or towards something. And your justice is going to be found there, okay? And it's going to lead you to your Queen of Pentacles, your divine inheritance. Speak your truth no matter who it hurts. Stand up for what you believe in. Try to, you know, what I'm meaning by no matter who it hurts, what I'm saying is if it's something that's happened to you or something that you feel deeply in your heart, of course, you know, some of you, like me, have not wanted to step on others' toes and always wanted and have been super nice to everybody, and it's got you nothing but shit on in your life, pretty much. And you're done. You're setting boundaries, you're standing, it's time that you set your boundaries and you speak, you know, you can speak with kindness and compassion and still speak your truth. The Lovers here, there could be a choice, or there could be like a truth about a love situation for some of you. What is this Trust Your Path? Walking away from something hidden. Some of you may be walking away when it comes to love, or it could be family, it could be relocating away from family, away from everything you've ever known to start again. Something that is hidden is about to come to light. Pisces energy here. You have an offer coming in. That could be work, love, different. Yeah, Empress. This is going to, trusting your path and walking away from these people who no longer serve you, these situations, these things, is going to help you walk into your divine Empress energy, okay? There's a situation that's over and ended. It was part of your healing or your awakening. Sometimes people are divinely planted in our life for a season, even if it's a partner, even if it's like a best friend or a friend, or You know, not everybody is meant to stay. Not everybody is meant to, you know, be permanent forever. I want you to understand that, okay? What's this awakening? This person has helped you awaken. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. This is speaking your truth. Someone here could be juggling you. Just pay attention. This could be work. This could be love. Put it where it resonates. Or things need to be balanced out with a person, place, or thing. You may have an offer of money coming in that's going to help you balance things out. Could be from a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Doesn't have to be. I feel like you worked really hard. I feel like you do work hard. I feel like you don't get the rest that you deserve. Clarify the council, the light, divine orchestration, helpers, and subtle realms. So you have helpers that are helping you with these tower movements. These tower movements are coming to knock out everything that is not for your highest and greatest good. Okay, clarify the tower. Yeah, the choice is yours, though. Do you choose to listen to the divine, listen to your gut, listen to your intuition, your spirit team? Okay, the choice is yours. You can master, you can create anything. You're being called to transmute the negative and to make a positive. This is going to help you receive justice, okay? So, some of you may have a court situation or something you thought about maybe taking to court or someone. Know that you have helpers behind the scenes that are helping orchestrate something. Somebody here is going to get a lot of money from a lawsuit, okay? I heard, just be careful with who you choose. So I recommend, I use readings for the series. And, you know, since I've been doing them, they haven't led me wrong yet. But only go to a trusted person. Seek out counsel, seek out advice, you know, go with your gut, follow your intuition. It's like you're stepping into it from a page of coins energy to a king of coins energy as you trust yourself and you trust your path and you take this leap of blind faith, okay? Dance with life, do something to change your energy. I feel like people around you may be keeping your energy stagnant, or people you're running around, or they could be even like, they watch the news and it's low vibrational. Yeah, someone's in their head and they're in mental prison, and I feel like it's causing you to, it's affecting you in your life. You're the high priestess though, and you know the situation's over. Listen to your gut, follow your intuition, don't worry about what anybody else says is what I'm hearing here. What's this, take a break? Some of you may need to take a break from a person. Yeah, and celebrate with friends and family, or even just yourself. Take yourself out, shit. Okay. Yeah. I see you, like, celebrating with friends and family. You don't always have to work. I feel like some of you, like, resting is actually going to help you, lead you to this Queen of Coins, King of Coins energy, okay? You still have to rest and relax. Enjoy yourself. So some of you need to enjoy yourself this weekend. Don't, like, for example, like, I'm a reader. A lot of times people ask me to read, and I don't mind, and I love to read. I love, love, love it. Like, I could do it and get paid for it, and a lot of times, I don't ask for money, and that's okay. But I'll do it anyways, or I always ask people, or people ask me, and I jump to it, but sometimes I just need to rest. So that's a message for somebody. 13:45 o'clock it was when I looked up. So waters may be turbulent or not feel like they're calm now. The divine's going to move you out of these turbulent waters. They're moving you. They're orchestrating things behind the scene for you to get your justice and you to step into a money path, okay? Clarify the Akasha. Your guidance is divinely guided. So following this is going to lead you to your stability, okay? Also could be your divine partner, because we have the Emperor and the Empress on the board again, and this has been coming out a lot. And it doesn't always have to be a love partner. This could be a business partner as well, okay? But for most of you, I feel like this is love. Clarify the Emperor. Yeah, and it's going to give you the world in the palm of your hands. You're going to be able to, you're creating your heaven on earth and helping bring this new changes to the world, okay? So this is why you're being guided away from these people, places, and things that are not for your highest and greatest good. God, you're being guided. This is going to happen quicker than what you think as soon as you take this blind leap of faith, okay? And I feel like there may be people around that are very immature. They think with their thinking with my as the song I'm hearing, or their hoo-ha, whatever. And they're too concerned with sexual matters, and I feel like it's causing some kind of throwing them off, messing up their vibration, maybe yours as well. Yeah, some of those things are stuck and stagnant, okay? It's time for you to get out of this if it's not growing. You don't have to move immediately. You don't have to do this immediately. I'm hearing do it wisely and smart, you know. Some of you may need to save money. Just because you're not being abused doesn't mean it's a good, doesn't mean it's the situation you should be in, is what I just heard. You're going towards the sun, Knight of Pentacles, with inner temple devotion. Tune into the portals of your heart, which is going to lead you to self-love with a new romantic start somewhere. But you have to cut out the love, the people, places, and things in love that don't resonate with you any longer. Being guided to be strong with Leo energy here. Knight of Coins. Is there the stability? The Ace of Wands, a new passionate new start that's going to lead you to the ultimate fulfillment of love. The King of Coins, I mean. Look at this. He keeps coming out. Somebody here is, there's a King of Coins. Could be an Earth sign. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Doesn't have to be. That you're going to have a passionate new start with when it comes to love or business or both. So you're being guided to cut out those. And it could lead to marriage and even children. You could join each other to build something beautiful. We have the King and Queen on the Emperor and Empress and the King and Queen of Coins. So there's somebody, some of you here are going to join together with someone to build this. You're being divinely guided towards each other to start with a friendship, to build it, to possibly a business and even love for some of you. Or you may work with this person. Money's involved somehow. Yeah, the divine's leading you up out of a situation to take you to your purpose, where you're meant to be. Okay, it's gonna happen quickly. You have tons of options. You just need to trust. Your prayers are being heard by the divine. Like, this is coming in fast and quick. Okay, King of Cups, someone wants to emotionally love you. I feel like you're conflicted though. There's conflicts within yourself or within a loving love situation or a family dynamic. Someone isn't realizing that you are the blessing or what to do. I feel like you intimidate somebody by your energy, your aura, your confidence, or your growing confidence. You have wish fulfillment here after a lot of pain. Self-made, 9-9 is significant. There are endings coming to catapult you to these new beginnings. Judgment's been called. This new soulmate energy is coming in. This now may not be the right time for you to make this move. I'm hearing, you know, you have to take the action steps towards what you're being guided to do, right? Show the divine that you have trust. For example, like if you were gonna wanted to get a promotion or a raise, you have to go in and ask for it, or you have to apply for it and ask for it. You see what I'm saying? So timing may not be right now, but it's coming soon. You're about to gain clarity on a love situation or about someone. It could have been someone from the past. There's been a lot of pain here. Some of you need to heal on your own and love yourself. I'm sorry, but it's true. It's what the divine's saying. And take that blind leap of faith. You're about to gather a harvest here about something you're very passionate about. It's going to lead you to... You have unexpected financial gains coming in. And they could come in many, many, many ways. But if you don't rest, choose rest when you need to rest and release this toxicity, it's going to make you sick. I'm sorry. There could be a soulmate from your past that wants to come back in and collaborate with you, or several. So just be careful. Don't. I feel like some of you are carrying other people. You carry other people's, like, you're an empath, and you carry people's pain and emotions. Like, they don't understand how much it weighs you down. Your ships are about to come in, okay? 63 could be significant, or you could be 36. I see, like, you've given a lot, and now you're something is coming in that's equal reciprocation for you. There is a mother energy here, or sisterly energy, or I mean, it could be, it's a family dynamic is what I'm feeling that shouldn't be trusted. Someone is throwing stones and hiding hands at the, like, they judge you, but they need to worry about their own life, okay? Like, I'm going to be honest, I'm picking up on, like, this person judges you for everything you've ever done, but they're living a secret life. And I feel like you know, but you're not the one. You don't go telling other people's business, even though you do know. And some of you, they have dumbed you down for your psychic abilities because they don't want you, they think that if you're too close to them, you'll find out. But you already know, but you're like me and you don't tell, right? Somebody here is being moved to this so they can go into hermit mode, which is going to catapult them forward, okay? And there's somebody in the King of Wands energy here who's very passionate about you, that does not want to lose you or give you up, but yet they are sulking in their own sorrow instead of like fixing things. Remain balanced and tempered. I see you are going to have a victory no matter what. Keep pushing forward. You're protected from all harm. Just try to release this lack mindset and this depression, okay? I'm hearing some of you may be going to therapy soon. I know me and my daughter, we started therapy, and I'm very excited about it. And I know that it's going to help me. And so don't be afraid to seek help, okay? Especially those of you who've been through a lot of trauma. I see a lot of hard work being put in. Oh, and by the way, guys, like, I manifested my insurance and all, I want to pay for it. And I manifested that it's completely paid for me and my daughter. With no worries. And this is a great therapist, and there's tons and tons at an amazing college, and there's tons and tons and tons of different styles that they teach to do therapies, because one of my doctors wanted me to do light therapy for the trauma I went through, and other modalities, because they know I don't want medication if I don't have to. And it's not saying don't take medication. If you need to take it, take it. But for me personally, I'm moving away from that stuff and trying more natural alternatives. That's just what's right for me, but that may not be right for you. Remember, I'm not a doctor, a lawyer, or anything like that, so please seek professional help. This is for entertainment purposes only. I see you, but anyways, you get what I'm saying. Somebody here is jealous or spying on your Ten of Cups, because you're about, like, somebody here is, see you walking into a Ten of Cups, this could lead to marriage, like, happy family. Others do not want you to be happy. They're jealous of what they think you got going on, right? There could be children involved here. There could be issues with a child that ends up in court for somebody. I feel like you will be successful if you go for child support or you go for any kind of legal thing. Yeah, it's going to happen quick, fast, and in a hurry. Some of you will settle out of court with the Ten of Pentacles. It's going to help build, it could be generational wealth. From death comes rebirth. You're going to rise like the phoenix, speaking your truth. So step out of the stagnant energy and trust the divine. That was the whole tech, y'all. That's beautiful energy. So only take what resonates, of course, from what I... We're going to tap into these sacred spirit cards. I thought this was the original deck with the book, but it wasn't. I should have checked into it better. It says expansion. So some of you are going through a dark night of the soul, or, you know, I feel like we go through more than one. Or you've been going through one, and life is bringing you new meaning with this dark night of the soul. And it's helping you expand, you have expansion, educate your mind and senses. So it's helping you expand your consciousness. The energy of this is mindful wisdom, create inner harmony. You're learning that as within, so without truly means, like, if there's a fear, like, or, it, like, if someone says, oh, don't do that, and, like, your team's telling you to do it, it's a fear within them, but there may be, it also is reflecting the fear within you, okay? That's just an example. You have astral travel. Some of you have always been astral traveling. You just don't realize it when you're sleeping. Some of you may actually consciously learn to do this. But there's caution needed, so you need to make sure that you are protected. You have up your shields. You have your team with you. What you believe in, you know, just be careful. Learn how to do it properly. Number 11, 16, and 5 is significant, as well as 4. Awakened spirit is here. So you have a desire for a change. Or desire to change and for change. So that change starts with you. You know? You can have the life that you're desiring. It's nothing is too far out of your reality. Anything can be accessed if you have the power, if you believe and you learn to work with the universe, not against it. 15, emotional challenges. So some of you have some emotional challenges here, and you need to resolve this issue within and without. So as you saw within you, you can solve it with others. And 14, energy signature. The past is in the present. Some of you have these emotional challenges because of things you went through in the past. I bought a from Healing Intuitions, guys. Go follow her. She's freaking amazing. I love her. I would love to collab with her, but you know, she's got her own thing going on, and she don't even know who I am, really. But anyways, I just love her spirit. I love her energy. She's amazing. She does trauma spotting, and you can buy the video for a lifetime for $18.18. You can do private things with her, and I bought it, and it's amazing. Or you can buy it, rent it for like 3 days. You guys need to go check her out. Healing Intuitions. She has Corey's Apothecary or something like that. .com. Her name's Corey. But anyways, y'all, please go check her out. If you get a chance to try that trauma spotting, it is amazing and it works, and it takes you back to a time and you are able to heal it. The divine's called in. It's great stuff. I actually want to be certified to do it. I actually want maybe have her teach me to do it is my goal. But we'll see what happens, and if the divine wants us to work together, they will cross our paths. But yeah, that's what I'm hoping for. But please go check her out, Corey's Apothecary. But she's on Healing Intuitions on YouTube. She's freaking amazing, you guys. I love her. Our message is often aligned. I always post my messages, and I always watch her stuff to support her. Click it, you know. I support fellow readers that I align with, and I try to stay away from like most of the main, you know, most readers. So, and our energy often aligns. But yeah, so you have to heal this emotional challenge here, because it's in your energy signature. So this needs to be, you need to find what it is, what the trigger is, what caused it. Like today she talked about something with her mother or her stepmother and father that happened. And some things came up with me when she was talking about when I was doing my trauma spotting, and it was with my mom. So there are some things that probably need to be healed. And remember, don't blame them. It was just where they were at in their consciousness at the time is what spirit is saying, okay? Let's get some angel cards out here. Actually, we're going to go with the goddess guidance oracle. It's still been a long time since I've used a whole deck. 27:24 on the clock. Do you let me know if you like these shorter readings better as well? If you guys like a subject or topic read on, if you want your energy in it, you can just say what topic and your energy will be in that. If you would like, you can email me too if you get a certain reading you guys want. It says easy does it, Unaga. There is no need to hurry or force things to happen. Everything is occurring in perfect timing. And you have Cavencia, purification. It's time for a cleansing, detoxification of your body and mind. So maybe you need to like go on a vacation. Some of you need to just be with just yourself or just like your own time. I'm feeling here because like the hermit was very prevalent in this reading. Your life purpose could involve guiding children with Demaria. You are good at helping, counseling, and healing children. Use your skills to help children now. Pele, divine passion. Be honest with yourself. What is your heart's truest desire? And I just had a download for myself. Let me write this down real quick. Okay, sorry about that. Divine passion, be honest with yourself. What is your heart's true desire? It could be like you stepping into your divine union within self. It could also be your divine partner. This is like, what are you passionate about? What could you do without getting paid? Or what is your biggest dreams, desires? Speak them. You have Butterfly Maiden. Transformation. You are experiencing enormous change right now, which brings great blessings. And Diana asked you that you have focused intentions. Keep your unwavering thoughts, feelings, and actions focused on your target, and you will make the mark, okay? So it's important that you speak it, like, thank you so much, universe, God, whatever it is that you believe in, for this amazing new car or this amazing new home, and be detailed about it, okay? Like whatever it is you're trying to, the new job, whatever it is you're trying to manifest, okay? You have Kuan Yin, and any of these goddesses that I mentioned, you can work with them. They are just ascended masters. It's not about worshiping them. I don't even think they wanted to be worshiped. like mainstream society has transformed things because they don't want us to know our true power, okay? And we're tapping back into the power of the divine feminine. Women are coming back into power where they should have been a long time ago, million years ago. Of course, they erased in our history, but we were very powerful. Women were, you know, and it's about equal, you know, and because we have compassion and things that, so we're stepping into the power of the divine feminine, whether they like it or not. Just saying. And, you know, not that guys aren't good too. I'm just saying. You know what I mean? We're stepping away from, like, blue and red, black and white. We're stepping out of duality and into oneness, okay? Kuan Yin, compassion. Release judgments about yourself and others and focus on love and light that is within everyone. And Freya says, be bold. Unleash your adventurous side. Take risks and be daring. If you need to tap into that boldness, you can work with Freya. She's amazing. Kuan Yin's amazing to work with. I also mentioned Isis earlier, so some of you, any of those that I mentioned. And your final one is Siege, quiet time. Take some quiet time alone to rest, meditate, and contemplate. And don't back down with Bridget. Stand up for what you believe is right. Even if you're standing alone, is what I just heard the divine said. Even if you're standing alone, okay? So, let me get the Archangel Michael deck, and then we'll move forward, okay? Sword of Light. All right, Archangel Michael, what guidance, or what do you have for this beautiful, beautiful collective that I love so much? I really am appreciative, guys. I know there's not a lot of you that comment or that like or whatever, and that's okay, but if you could, please just, if you watch this, even if it doesn't resonate with you, please like it or comment something, even an emoji, like if you're ready to take the leap of faith in you or ready for the life of your dreams, but like any kind of emoji that speaks to you down at the bottom, that helps get it in the algorithm. Prioritize self-care, number 24. You do so much for others. It's time to experience the love that you deserve and let others help you. Don't give up on love. A relationship you cherish can be healed. Allow me to clear away a way for forgiveness so that love can thrive again. This could be romantic. This could be like family. This could be friendship. Just love in general. But first, you got to love yourself. You got to make yourself happy before you can make anybody else happy. Deeper insights are at hand. Number 8. Your overall plan is good, but the details need work. Reflect before moving forward. What else, Archangel Michael, for this beautiful collective? Thank you. 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 It says, pray from the heart. Number 23. Prayer really can move mountains. Reach out to the divine with your heart's concerns and watch miracles unfold. Your vibration is rising, number 43. This is a time of great spiritual growth for you. You're evolving to occupy a higher energetic frequency. And those that are not aligned with you are like going backwards or not, you know, evolving themselves. You will be separated from them. It doesn't mean that you can't talk to them or be friends with them or whatever. It just means that, you know, it's just something that happens, and it doesn't mean it's bad. Remember, people are sometimes are in our life for, very rarely are they in their life forever. They're usually in there for a season, a lesson, a blessing, you know, a brief time. Number 25, put your creative energy into action. Archangel Gabriel joins me, Archangel Michael, to spark your creativity, help you communicate your vision and motivate you to create something beautiful. So ask Archangel Gabriel. He's the angel and messenger of communications and creativity to help you with your creativity. And number 6, be the real you. Your greatest power comes from being who you truly are. Don't let anyone sway you from expressing your authentic self. And 15, increase your knowledge. Some of you could be going back to school, taking classes, even just like, there's a lot of free classes out there, guys. Don't be afraid to, like, you know, Udemy even has free classes. Don't be afraid to like research those things, okay? And education brings opportunities. Take a course, pick up a book, or find a mentor to teach you what your song longs to know. Number 30 and final one is step into the spotlight. You have a message that the world needs to hear. It's time that you share your wisdom because you've been through so much, and have no fear, okay? Fear is a trap of the ego. Allow me to use my sword of light to free you from your disqualifying feelings that are holding you back. You're gonna get a huge upgrade once you do this. You just, it's kind of like huge, okay? Like, it's gonna blow your mind. Like, I'm happy for you guys. If anyone needs a private reading, any type of reading, we can work something out. We'll do it for donation, whatever. I haven't been charging for readings, but I'm getting to a point now where, you know, at least I want to do maybe a donation base or something. We'll see. I promise you guys I would do the first live free, and I will. And I will always do one card free one cards after anyone with donations goes first, or you know, we'll see how it goes, what the divine guides me to do. But I love you all so, so much. Thank you all for hanging out. Oh, yeah, angel number 331. I was supposed to read to you guys. I forgot. Sorry. This says request. Solidify what you're asking for. Your prayers are being heard, but your angels want you to streamline them. Organize exactly what you want and reflect on the best ways to ask for it. In a journal, form a complete request that sequentially ask for what you want in life. Okay? All right, guys. I love you all. I hope you guys have an amazing day, morning, night, and the rest of your soon-to-be weekend. Okay? I should be on to record something today or tomorrow. I will not be, probably won't be on Saturday, or you may see a video Saturday or Sunday if we have time. I have a wedding to go to, and we were going to try to record a 10-minute video at least for TikTok. I've tried to share the last one here, but it wouldn't let me because it was done on her phone, so I'm going to record to you this time. But remember to go like Reiki Me Right. It's spelled R-E-I-K-I-M-E-R-I-G-H-T. Okay. And that is where you will be able to see me live. Once I get to 1,000, I'm going to be giving away stuff. You'll be able to see me more shorter videos if you like, if that's your kind of thing. Okay. I love you guys so much. Thank you all for everything again. Until we meet again.